in Israel.
Hello again. So I'll present the serological, the long-term serological response response to FMD vaccination. Again, this work was done by Dr. Udi Nekave, and I especially also want to thank Dr. Boris Gelman from the Israel Kimron Veterinary Institute, who actually performed a lot of the tests, and also to our colleagues in CVI in the Netherlands for performing the other tests. So a little bit about how we vaccinate cattle in Israel. We use a commercial vaccine by Merial. It's the Aftopor. It's a high potency dose vaccine, more than 6 PD50. The same vaccine is used for routine and also for emergency vaccination. It's a trivalent vaccine, which contains sub serotypes of OA and ASIA1. The first vaccination is administered usually between 2 and 3 months of age, and the second vaccination up to 3 months later, and then there is an annual vaccination. A little bit about what we know about vaccine effectiveness in cattle and the prior experience that we have. So we know that dairy cattle are rarely affected during FMD outbreak. I show it to you in the previous presentation. And when they are affected, only young animals show clinical disease. And I mean not suckling calves, but animals that are less than 2 years old. Young animals are only partial, but in a study that we performed during an outbreak in 2011, we saw that young animals are only partially protected from clinical morbidity, despite multiple vaccinations. And by this, I mean most of them were vaccinated up to three times. And emergency vaccination is very, very effective in controlling the outbreak. So we had a problem. We see something in the field. We see that young animals are more affected than old animals, and we wanted to see what is the reason for this finding. So we hypothesized that it takes more than a certain number of vaccinations to elicit a stable immune response. And that, or maybe the age of the initial vaccination influenced not only the response to the first vaccines, but it influences the response to the vaccine for a very long term. And the question elicited from this hypothesis were that what is the number actually of vaccination needed to elicit a stable immune response? And what is the ideal age for administration of first vaccination? And what is the best vaccination schedule to elicit a good immunological coverage during the first 2 years of life? And this is because there is some contradicting evidence from the literature regarding the best age for vaccination. We aim to estimate the long-term antibody dynamics. First, in routinely vaccinated cows and heifers of different vaccination statuses, and in non-vaccinated calves after ingestion of colostrum and after vaccination in different ages and in different levels of maternal immunity. So the results of these two studies were recently published in Vaccine, in two articles in Vaccine. So the first study, we vaccinated 45 heifers and 54 cows, and the heifers were divided to three groups. One group that got one vaccine before the study, two vaccines, three vaccines, and then for the cows, four vaccines, five vaccines, and more than six vaccines. The first, you will see in my figures, that the first group we called group A, then B, C, etc. As you can see, we followed them for for two years, and we gave them a trivalent vaccine, and then another trivalent vaccine a year later, and these are all the blood sampling. So when I'm just giving a representation of two of the groups, but believe me, and you can see in the article if you want, the other groups were, these are representative groups of other similar groups. And as you can see, that the ones that were getting the just one vaccine, they had a good booster reaction to the vaccine, but there was a reduction in the antibody titer. Here you can see actually an arbitrary cut of two for that might represent protection. Since we do not have specific challenges for these exact titers. And this is what happened with the four and higher vaccination. You see that there is almost no response to vaccination, but the titer is very, very stable and mostly remain above this cutoff. When you look just at the antibodies, at the level of antibodies, I forgot to say that we tested this sera for several serotypes. I present only the one that were tested for 0, 4, 6 to 5, but they were also tested for Asia 1 Shamir and for O Manisa and also for O 4A Turkey, which is not homologous with the strain in the vaccine, but it's very similar. So you can see that in the more vaccinations group, you see that they come to the first vaccination, they enter the study with higher titer of antibodies. You can pay attention that there is this group C, the groups that got three vaccinations, is different than the other group. I will not go into it now, but if you'll have time, we can talk about this because it's very interesting. This group is very interesting. So if we look at the proportion of animals with titer higher than a cutoff of two, and along the time from vaccination, we can see that in the higher vaccination group, the decay or the animals that go below the titer of two is much lower than what we see in the less vaccination animals. In the other study, we looked at non-vaccinated calves, and then we vaccinated in different conditions. One in one group was under 1 month, then 1 to 2 months, 3 to 4 months, and 5 to 6 months, and these are the names of the groups. Try to remember them. And after this, and as you can see, we vaccinated them in day zero, then after 4 weeks, then a trivalent vaccine after 19 weeks, and another trivalent vaccine for half of these groups, after 34 weeks. There is also, because there was a SAT2 outbreak near Israel, we also vaccinated them with the monovalent SAT2 vaccine, but we didn't analyze it, so this is the last time I will mention it. First, looking at, we could analyze the decay of the maternal antibodies, by looking at the levels of antibodies before vaccination in all these groups. And we found with this simple method, we found the results that were very similar to what the published results, with a half time of the antibodies of 22 days, which is very similar to results to follow up to cohort result studies. But the very, very interesting results came out when we look at the entire period So what you can see here, you see this is, for example, the group that was vaccinated before the age of 1 month. And as you can see, the booster vaccination doesn't elicit any antibodies. And not just that it doesn't elicit any antibodies, it's the decay of antibodies after further vaccination is very fast. And you see in green where they didn't get, the group that didn't get the fourth vaccination, and in blue the group that did, that got the fourth vaccination. And it's also in the second group with 1 to 2 months. Okay, you see it almost does not elicit an antibody response, and also the decay is very fast. While when you look at the group from 3 months on, and here is 3, 4, and 5, 6, you see that there is a very good response, and there is the antibody level remains for a long time. So we try to analyze this and to look actually at the amount of time that each group stayed. I hope I will be clear with this. Had an antibody titer above a cutoff of 2, above of cutoff 2, between the ages 6 months and 1.5 years. And as you can see, the group that was group D, which was vaccinated at 5 to 6 months, actually most of the time it was above this cutoff. And also this group C, you see that a lot of the time it was above the cutoff. While group B and A, there was only just a small part of the time they were above this cutoff. Now, some of you can say that how did we choose this cutoff? I said it's an arbitrary cutoff. So we made another analysis. We looked at the percentage of animals above any cutoff. Here you see in the x-axis, this is the cutoff, and the percentage of animals above this cutoff. So here, for example, above the cutoff of 2, you can see that group C of D and D it's not the percentage of animal, it's the percentage of time between half a year and 1.5 years. Above this cutoff, and you can see that there are 70% that they are above this cutoff in 70% of the time. While you can also look at what is the number that are above this, what is the percentage of time that they are above a cutoff of 1.4, if you draw a line here. And as you can see that for all cutoffs, vaccinating at older age is much more efficient in eliciting a long-term response, antibody response. So, to conclude, we saw that 5 vaccine doses provide long-lasting immunity. And given the fact that emergency vaccination is always warranted during an outbreak, the effectiveness of vaccinating after 5 vaccination, maybe it should be reassessed. I know it's a little maybe revolutionary, but we wanted to follow a part of this group for another year without vaccination, but we weren't allowed to do it. And with vaccination of calves, so vaccination prior to the age of 3 months doesn't elicit good AB response, not just after vaccination, which some of the studies showed before, but also impairs the entire immunological response later on. And when I just, a brief sentence about that group that was vaccinated 3 times, actually when we went back, okay, you remember this group? You see also for the vaccine in the second year, okay, they have very low titers. When we went back and saw when this particular group, cohort, was vaccinated, they were actually vaccinated at very young age. So we see here, maybe, with this a part of the study, we see here maybe a very long-term effect of the first age of vaccination of these calves. And with this, I will end. Thank you.
Perfect. Thank you very much. So are there any time for probably one quick question, if there is one? Yeah.
The question here is, then, what we consider as emergency vaccination. Which situation is emergency? If we're talking about 5 vaccinations or whatever, if we're talking about vaccination of calf born from vaccinated dams, I don't think this is emergency. According to my understanding, is emergency is the case when it just either the animals are directly exposed to risk, or there is a case and we need quick prompt titer, high titer, and until we organize the other anti-epidemic measures and all the activities. Just this is what we have to discuss, I think.
Okay.
So emergency vaccination, what I mean emergency vaccination is vaccination in the face of an outbreak. I mean, you have an outbreak in a herd, you vaccinate the entire herd. This is what I refer as emergency vaccination.
Okay, I think that's enough. And just to, a small plug, we're going to be discussing this in Group G7, how to optimize vaccination schedules in endemic settings tomorrow morning. So please come along. I know AR will be there as well, so you'll be able to continue discussions there. Okay, so the next presentation.